right, so we're starting. It's actually Friday afternoon. I've been working on getting here all day. It's been a real hassle just to make it this far. Nothing's wanted to go on, nothing wanted to fit, nothing wanted to just go smoothly. You know how those things are. But I am here. Nobody got hurt. Equipment is running, and I am about to start hammering away at this piece of property. Now, it's a two-part job. One is, it is bush hogging. And the other part is actually moving debris. So, let me see if these things. Suspicious that this area has hidden obstacles that are going to come to light when I at least expect them. I know there's dead wood all over the place. That was part of the deal, that he wants me to pick up dead wood. And today, since it's late on Friday, my objective is to simply cut the outlines, get a good look at the property. Try to pick up the tempo. And it was cracked. correct. So it's just going to take a while. You know, there's a fair number of trees, which always adds to the difficulty and the time. It's usually like the biggest factor is the trees. How many trees do you have to cut around? How close do you really have to get to the trees? How particular is the customer going to be? And then try to price it so you don't lose money. And what I did was I just asked him, I said, hey, what kind of prices are you getting? And he said, well, somewhere between $3,000 and $5,000. And I kind of wish I'd gone higher, but I just don't think it's going to take that long. I could be wrong. You know, I told him I'd run for 2 days and, you know, do what I can in that time period. So, we'll see how that goes. I did bring this one, particular bush cutter. Obviously, I want the bigger cutter for a couple different reasons. One is there's a lot of wood on the ground, and this is rated for 4 inches. But also, you know, obviously being a bigger property, being able to get on top of this stuff and do it in one pass versus, you know, 7 or 8. It's going to be very beneficial to have a bigger machine. Biggest stress over getting started on this whole thing was where I was going to park. Friday. It concerns me that this is going to be a long weekend. I got to stop and let this thing cool off as frequently as it looks like it's going to require. Check my engine coolant. That's not a problem. So I don't know where the problem lies. All right, we are back. Today is day three and the final day. You can see how nice the property looks from what it was originally. It's amazing what a good cut will do to transform the look of a piece of property. The nice part is that they've got another 20 acres. They're so happy with this that they want me to come back in a couple months and take care of the other 20 acres, which is just as rough as what this started out to be. So. I'm looking forward to that. And I wanted to say that the reason I was able to do this job is because of the Rhino cutter. Honestly, it's too big for a 6-foot cutter. You would have been here absolutely forever doing this. I would have had to price it at triple what I charged. And if you look at just the hours cutting, it was over $200 an hour. When you throw in the other expenses, my drive time, and you know, things like that, it's gonna bring that down. But I couldn't have done this job, and the customer couldn't have had this job done by a cutter that was less capable than the Rhino unit that I have, which can cut up to 40, or up to 4 inches. So investing in the heaviest one that I could buy is paying off. So let's say, you know, this year I could earn $7,000 just on one customer for this unit, and that unit cost $22,000. So over the course of the life of the unit, if I could earn $7,000 a year minimum because I have that particular cutter, then obviously it pays for itself in 3 years. Now, if that's the only job I ever got with it, then you know, it'd be 3 years, but obviously I can get more work, I can do bigger jobs, and you know, do things that other people can't if they only have a 5-foot cutter, which I understand is, you know, it's a major investment to get something of this size. But if you're gonna do bigger property, you really don't have a choice. If you're gonna do rougher property, you really don't have a choice. So, you know, it makes me different than what a lot of the other guys around here can do. And you'll see what I'm about to get into. I've got another hour or so here today to finish this property off to where I want to get it. There are some areas over in the picture to be over to the right, behind this first clump and the second clump, that I'm not even gonna bother. There's complete down trees in there and I can't move trees. So I'm gonna clean up what's right in front of me and then basically done. Then I gotta get out of here. This property is extra challenging because the road coming in, they built themselves, and is nothing but sugar sand. And I can't get a piece of, I can't get the trailer down here. There's no possible way. I can barely get by dually down here without getting stuck. I had to hammer it yesterday leaving just not to get stuck on the road. So, you know, requires parking a ways away, transporting, you know, driving equipment in, shuttling, things of that nature to effectively, you know, to do this. So I'm gonna get fired up, do a little bit more cutting, and then call it a day, and then actually take everything back to the farm, my farm, and start swapping implements in preparation for a big job, big dirt moving job that we've got scheduled for next week. So let's go ahead and get started. cutter off, move the wood, and then come back and cut again in the areas where I removed the wood from. So it's going to be 2 long days for sure. So I wanted to get something done today to help get this thing started and make sure the tractor's going to work all right. Back later. Thank you. right, we are back. Today is day three and the final day. You can see how nice the property looks from what it was originally. It's amazing what a good cut will do to transform the look of a piece of property. The nice part is that they've got another 20 acres. They're so happy with this that they want me to come back in a couple months and to get it. There are some areas over in the picture to be over to the right, behind this first clump and the second clump, that there's just, I'm not even going to bother. There's complete down trees in there and I can't move trees. So I'm going to clean up what's right in front of me and then basically done. Then now I got to get out of here. This property is extra challenging because the road coming in, they built themselves and is nothing but sugar sand. And I can't get a piece of, I can't get the trailer down here. There's no possible way. I can barely get my dually down here without getting stuck. I had to hammer it yesterday leaving just not to get stuck on the road. So, requires parking a ways away, transport, driving equipment in, shuttling, and things of that nature to effectively, to do this. So I'm going to get fired up, do a little bit more cutting, and then call it a day, and then actually take everything back to the farm, my farm, and start swapping implements in preparation for a big job, big dirt moving job that we've got scheduled for next week. So let's go ahead and get started. Should have pulled farther forward on that one. But you can see I can back all the way through this stuff and not have to come back to it later. Take a big chunk of the cutting process out. Deadwood on the ground is what this big mower is needed for. Everything else in between is not a big deal. It's just you can't avoid running over all the down stuff. I did determine that I was running the cutter too low, which was leading to some of the overheating. It still runs hot, and I think it's just too much mower for 74 horsepower. I mean, if I had to buy another one, I'd probably buy a 110 horsepower tractor.